Two potential ways to recover your native ultimate. This could be the solution to your safety issues.
Welcome back. If you're new to the channel, we cover kayak modifications, spin, and fly fishing. So poke that subscribe button so you don't miss anything.
Before we get started, I need to issue a disclaimer. I am not a canoe or kayak recovery expert. I'm just a guy trying to figure this out after talking to a few folks and looking around the internet and native for advice on how to recover a boat that looks like the native ultimate. So take this with a grain of salt. These are my efforts to keep myself safe by doing the practice before the inevitable happens. And if you've looked at my other videos, and I'll link them up in the description below, you've seen that I've tried multiple ways to try and recover this boat. Well, I've been getting sympathetic responses from some of my viewers, and today I'm going to try out two methods that were suggested to me. I think both have a lot of promise. The first method is fairly simple. I'm going to float here in the deep end, and the technique is that I turn around, I lift up the end of the boat to make it float on the flotation installed in the rear, and then flip it, throwing it as high up into the air as I possibly can. That way, it will not scoop up the water as it turns over. So let's give that method a try. First thing I'm going to do is break the seal. Then, while treading water, I'm going to lift up and flip. And I've got to call that a fail right now. This boat weighs about 70 pounds, and with the water inside the gunnels, it's just too heavy to lift up without standing on the bottom. If I stand on the bottom, I can do it. But you can't count on flipping in shallow water. So we've got to go and try the other option on the flip on. So I'm going to rock the boat a little bit and try and get more air in there. Okay, that's about as best as it can do. Okay, so let's look at this flip line suggestion. So now I've taken my stand-up assist rope, and I'm going to hook it in the middle on the other side into my gunwale, and then I'll use this across here as my flip line. I'm going to put my feet right here, get as far down in the water as I can, and then I'm going to push up. Essentially, this is a different variation of the pull and push technique that I tried out in my very first video. Now let's try the technique. And then I'm going to thrust up vigorously. And that's plenty of free space here to be able to bail this thing out while I'm hanging on to the side. You still need that additional flotation that I talked about in my very first video. Otherwise, this thing is going to sink farther into the water. Well, that was educational, and I'm glad that I had access to this pool to do this practice, because now I have a little bit more confidence on how I'm going to recover this boat if I happen to dump out there when I'm fishing inshore. But the bottom line is, everyone needs to practice. The challenge, of course, will be to do this with a gear in the kayak. You know, once you have all your stuff in there, the boat is even heavier. I'm really encouraged by this. There's probably about 3 inches of free space there where I can bail this water out fairly easily while I float along the side. If you've got another idea for how to fix this problem other than the canoe flotation bags that I'm thinking about, please throw it in the comments below. I'd sure appreciate it. Thanks.